It's all about humanity. about humanity.
It's lights out and away we go!
Did I go for it? Did I send it? Or did I don't didn't send it?
Yeah, you
oh, send it!
Oh no, my shoes!
Okay mate, we got a few hard ones today. We got Kvyat and the two Willies have gone hard. Everybody else with a free choice is medium, apart from Jimenazzi, who's gone soft.
Thank you for that very precise information, Geoff.
Yes, it's pole position!
Tonight, Christo spins at turn 3. Constant Ryan sets one insane hot lap in quali. Semper uses the wrong pit lane entry. And Sweezy's probably gonna swear again.
It's Gareth. Right, come on. Where is the new thing?
Oh no, my shoes!
Okay mate, we got a few hard ones today. We got Kvyat and the two Willies have gone hard. Everybody else with a free choice is medium, apart from Jimenazzi, who's gone soft.
Thank you for that very precise information, Geoff.
It's lights out and away we go!
Just getting something sorted, guys. Give me a few moments and hopefully the new premiere will be here. Because there is something we are looking to premiere tonight here in SFR. But it would be just my luck that when I want to get it to work, it doesn't want to work. It would be just my luck, wouldn't it? Of a workaround. I can do a workaround. I will do the workaround this way instead then.
Do you know what that was? That was a smooth operator! Smooth operation!
Carlos, check the radio. We seem to have picked up some dodgy music channel again.
Boy. Work this way, please. And then... looking at the one. Why is it? Whenever I try and do something, this one wants to work. Well, whilst we're waiting for everything to sort itself out, guys, at my end. Good evening. Welcome to SFR. Apologies that tonight's race is a week later than originally scheduled. Unfortunately, we did have some emergencies last week that needed to be attended to by members of the SFR administrative team. So the decision was made very, very late notice to unfortunately cancel last week's event. But don't worry, you haven't missed anything, because what should have happened last week is about to happen tonight. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to include the party audio, and I will say, my name is KieranWright92, and of course it is a Saturday night, it is SFR night, which means I am joined by the man who is arguably the voice of SFR. He is the one, the only, T.E.S. Swayze! Good evening, Swayze.
Good evening, Kieran. Good evening, SFR fans. Good evening to all you out there on Twitch. What an introduction, Kieran. What can I say? Thank you very much. And of course, you're right with the intro earlier on. Swayze probably is going to fucking swear.
There it is! That's one of the three predictions from the returning Top Gear intro. Swayze is probably going to swear.
I'm not so sure on the voice of SFR, though. I'll happily sit in my little co-coms box with you and let you take the lead on this all day long, because I just enjoy being here, enjoy listening to you.
I am focused.
I enjoy my Saturday nights almost as much as my Sunday nights will.
Good. Alright, hopefully, if I've done this right, hopefully I've been able to get a workaround on the thing that didn't want to work initially.
Well, that's not good. Technology always causing problems.
Yeah, it's fine. We can work around these things. It's all good. We can work around these things.
You can. My laptop shut itself about a year and a half ago. I had to give up being a team owner, and I haven't replaced the bastard thing since.
I mean, don't get me wrong. My thing still shits itself, but I think we are going to be good. If I hit play on that, hopefully this will play, and then I can make this full screen. Take it back to the start. Yes, I can. Booyah! Right! This is what was initially supposed to play after the timer ran out. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to mute the mic. Swayze is going to be quiet for a couple of minutes. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. And there you go, ladies and gentlemen. That is the brand new SFR intro. Hope you guys did enjoy that intro. That will now play before every single SFR event. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Hopefully you heard it all okay and everything was all fine and dandy on that level. Just waiting for the all clear from the powers that be that we are all good to jump into the lobby. So what we will do whilst we are waiting for that to happen, what are your predictions for this race tonight, Swiss?
I mean, I think it's going to depend on who shows up. Obviously, this, you know, you can never count out Constant Ryan. I'd like to see Will run strong. I know this is a track that's easier for the no traction drivers, so it'd be nice to see him do well with that change. But, you know, I think it's going to be Constant Ryan, Vapid, maybe Cam, Leclerc up the front. Usual battles, but of course in the midfield you never know what's going to happen. I mean, TES Science recently and the racing, what was he doing it with Mexico, but what a battle they had, you know, even in the mid, yeah, even in the midfield, man, it's a track where there's three DRS zones, lots of DRS trains. But again, it's one of those tracks, if you do have an accident, I think it's hard to make up time here. You've got to stay with the pack.
My thoughts are very, very similar to yours, Mr. Swite. I do definitely think that we are going to be in for a very, very good race this evening. We did temporarily lose Mr. Swayze there, but we should hopefully have him back. Now, Swayze, do you want to just talk for a sec?
I can always talk for a sec. It's getting me to stop talking. That's the problem.
Yeah, we are good. Right, so if I do that, move this onto the live screen. Onto the live screen like that. That should hopefully move over to what we need it to move over to. Lobby's open, by the way, Swayze.
Well, for real. I'm joining up with you.
Come on, work for me. Come on, what is going on? Work for me, come on. Connect. Thank you, there it is. There we go. You can now see everyone jumping into the lobby now, guys. Lobby is up, I am in, Swayze is in. Let's get these drivers in and let's get this show on the road. Of course, it is an hour delayed due to the Champions League final.
And keep it there rather than on the grass.
Indeed. Let's get it on the track and hopefully have no one ending up into the grass. But if my top prediction was anything to go by, Christo's going to spin at turn three. Christo, I love you. But from the races I've watched, you have a tendency of spinning, broski. So...
yeah, that top of the hill, that's got an awful exit with a camber. It's, I think, probably the most likely place to bin it on this track. Of course, that is unless you are greeners and you bin it in the pit lane.
Oh, God. Greeners, we do love you. It is yes, Austria, F1 XL. It is indeed. Just want to make sure, guys, you can definitely hear Swayze, right? Just because I know what...
I have infamous memories of this place. One time around this track, I accidentally killed TMS Matt 45, who was my teammate at the time. going into the final corner, I tried to go side by side and... I took air off of the yellow sausage curb and lost all control of the car and just straight through the air, straight into him.
Lovely!
Nothing like it. Yeah. Learn from that.
Right, so I do know, Swayze, we have got a couple of debutants racing with us tonight. We have Papa Goose, AG7.
Steering wheel. Claps on steering wheel here.
Good, good, good.
Steering wheel.
Hey! Racing for
hey!
Half.
Steering wheel, somebody
just
tell him Jordan to give it
to NL, who's just
come
jumped
on.
Into the lobby as well. He, if I remember rightly, is jumping into the Red Bull and will be teaming up with SC Cristo for the remainder of the season. So they are the two new...
Oh no, my shoes!
Well, welcome
okay, mate.
To
we got a few
SFR.
Hard ons today. We got Kvyat and two willies gone hard. Everybody else with a free choice is medium, apart from Jimenazzi, who's gone soft.
Thank you for the very precise information, Jav.
Indeed. Thank you, Jav, for the very, very precise information. We've got everyone just jumping into the lobby now. We've got Mr. Constant Ryan, which probably means that another one of my predictions is going to come true. We've made four predictions in the Top Gear style intro that we had at the start of the stream. One was that Swayze was probably going to swear again. He did that within about 10 seconds of us going live and us hearing his voice.
It can't be helped. It can't be helped.
We've got Constant Ryan attempting, well, more than likely going to set one fast lap in quali. And if he doesn't, I'm going to be really, really upset. Because this is going to be the one time where Constant Ryan lets me down. The last 3 weeks, Constant Ryan has done one hot lap at the end of qualifying. If he comes out and does a proper qualifying session in Austria, I'm going to cry.
Oh no. Anyway.
Oh no. Anyway. Of course, we have Cristo, and we do have Semper. So we could potentially have Semper driving down the wrong pit entry line. Drivers, if you are listening, please remember that you have to pay attention to that driver's briefing. That TES science did drop in SFR's Discord last week in preparation for last week's event. We'll be initially scheduled to run this. Please make sure that you do declare your intentions to box in the correct way by maintaining the inside line around turn 9 and running the correct way down into the pits. And of course, if you are a driver chasing a driver who does that, it is your responsibility to not hit the driver in front.
I am stupid.
Otherwise, you say that. Otherwise, you say what Senpot has just said. As you can see, we are 6 seconds. You guys won't see it because of the overlay. But we are a matter of seconds away from qualifying. There's the beep. Let's get into this lobby. You know, I'm gonna try and start something new, Sway. Just because why not? We've got 6 races or so left in SFR this season. Every week, I want us to make a ridiculous.
Moving up and down, side to side, like a roller coaster.
Surprises a day, like
so.
Oh,
just
what
just the most so the most obscure thing ever. So I'm going to say. TES Big Will qualifies top 3 rows on the grid.
I'm going to qualify. I'm going to go bigger. He finishes on the podium.
There we go. All the eggs are being thrown in the Big Will basket this evening, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm back in my Sunday night comms, mate. This is the track. I know he's not long gone, no TC, but I know, you know, he told me this is the track. It's the easiest to learn on and... the one where we've seen a dramatic improvement. So, shock of the day for Big Will. That's what I'm going for. Big Will podium.
There we go. You've heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen, from Mr. TES. He is predicting Mr. TES Big Will, his fellow Typhoon Esports member, is going to get himself on the podium. I've said top 3 rows on the grid at qualifying, so I've said top 6. That, Sway, looks very gloomy. I'm not going to lie.
Okay, that's on the dry race. All right. Rain changes everything. And you know that as much as I know that.
Dry quali, wet start to the race, dry end. Just been told by Semper and Chet. This
that is
be
very interesting.
It's going to be tasty. If you guys like wet conditions in Austria, as we all know, wet conditions do like to play a part. We have got the first couple of cars leaving the pit boxes now. We've got a Haas, and we have got a, which will be a Mercedes. I'm going to assume that's going to be Cam. We'll keep Kislevskaya. It's definitely going to be Mr. Papa Goose. It's Papa Goose and Kislevskaya, both out on the soft tyre. So Kazesco has gone ahead of Papa Goose on the outlaps. We've got a couple of other cars getting ready to leave the pits as well. We have got a... It looks to be potentially both of the Renault, or is it a McLaren Renault? It's a McLaren. It's a McLaren of Vapid Coot and the Renault of TS Big Will, who have, interestingly, both gone out on mediums, as has Tom Gorin in the race.
Yeah,
recent.
Tom Gorin, huh?
Interesting. But knowing this is going to be a wet start to the raceway, wouldn't it be better to just quali on soft, in your opinion?
Yeah. I think that's going to happen anyway. I feel like there's enough time, you know, to go out, have a feeler. Provided that you don't do something stupid and bin your car while you're out on the mediums, is, you know, have a feel around. But yeah, if it's guaranteed wet, it's always going to be softs for qualifying.
We are watching Kislesko on the run up to turn number 3 now. Obviously, we'll go purple in sector 1, first person to set a lap time. That's the corner where I have predicted Christo's going to have a little spinella. Put more on the laptop, stream on the phone. Go on, Jamie. What we like to see. Kislesko taking the nice, lovely turn 4. Slight hairpin there. It's a long turn. It's a double long left-hander.
Nice line, nice use of the curbs.
Very, very nice line there by Kislesko. We've got a few of the other guys starting to come out now as well. Kislesko now coming up to the final two corners of this Austrian Grand Prix track here at the Red Bull Ring.
He flew through the final corners.
Very close to those curbs. 104.085 for Mr. Kislesko. First time on the board. Papa Goose comes across the line. 107.
What do you think we're going to see today then in qualifying for the fastest lap? Do you think? Have a prediction at that? Let's have a guess at that one. Where do you think we're going to get into?
I think
102s.
I think Kislesko can definitely find time, so I'm going to say high 102s, low 103s. What do you think?
I feel like there might be a 102 out there for sure.
Tom Gorin on the run up to the line now. 105.2 from Tom Gorin, enough for P3. Jordy is just starting his hot lap. Papa Goose did unfortunately invalidate his lap. Kirby.
It looks like he is going again.
He is going again. The current time to beat is a 104.0 set by Kislesko in that Mercedes.
Oh, he's invalidated again.
He's got too close to those curbs. Gotta be really, really careful on there. So Kirby's gonna be the next one round to set a lap time. So we will watch TM Kirby go into the broadcast cam. Don't worry, Jamie, she's not the only one that got sunburnt.
Just Jordy just invalidated his lap.
Kirby 105.3, that was P4 on those medium tyres.
Christo next to come over the line. No, he's on an outlap, actually.
He's on an outlap, yeah. So he's just going to stop.
Yeah, Jordy behind him, invalidated.
It's just a hypothetical to see what that time would have been for Jordy.
Tom Gorman going over the line did improve, but stays in third.
Would have been a 105.5 from just Jordy, so that would have been enough for P5. So he would have just outscored Big Will there in terms of a lap time. Watch as Christo comes through sector 2 now. The two Red Bull drivers coming round to set lap times. Again, apologies if you can hear a horrible, dull buzzing in the background. It is my laptop fan, which is basically trying to tell me that my laptop is on its way out. Oh, Christo running very, very wide there in the second part of that double left hander of turn 7. Didn't invalidate though.
Both Cam and Constant Ryan are out on track as well.
Christo did not like that lap time and has come into the pit. Just
my God! What did you do?
What did you do?
You're bad! Oh my God!
Oh my God, guys,
we did it again!
Purple in 1.
Oh my God, yes!
B1 game!
We just won the race!
You're on the medium tyre.
Semper decides to Defen myself by playing the Pierre Gasly. We just won the race. I think he's getting a little bit too ahead of himself. There is Mr. Semper. 104.156 by Constant Ryan on medium tyres as Leclerc goes 103.7. Cam, what can Cam do? Coming up to the line now. This is going to be, this is an invalidated time by Cam. It would have been a 111.1, so Cam's really not had the best of lap time.
Probably backed out to save his ERS and might have invalidated earlier.
Tom Gorin's on a much slower lap. Jordy is also on a much slower lap. That's what Ryan will be doing. An in lap now. I went super wide on turn three, you couldn't tell from your angle. Ah, fair enough. Fair enough, Krista. Fair enough, my friend.
Yeah, you did. I saw that on his exit.
So let's have a watch of Papa Goose. See if he can get himself a valid lap time on the board now. Hopefully it doesn't get too close to these curves. It comes around turn four into Alex Albon death corner. Followed by Valtteri Bottas's lawn mowing services. Turns six and seven here. This is where he's had a few issues before. He's able to keep it in between the white lines this time though.
Through 103.5 for Cam in the meantime.
Woo! Go on, Cam.
Papa Goose Rapid now is flying.
Around the final corner, Papa Goose, 104.796. That is P7 for Papa Goose. Tempo has just started a lap. Rapid Coot has gone at half a second faster. Rapid Coot, 103.5, goes 8 tenths faster.
Look at that, there's nothing between Cam and Coot there. That battle is, oh, I love it.
These are the battles that gives DS Swayze a reason to wake up in the morning.
Yeah, and sometimes an erection.
Oh, jeez. So to anyone who may just be jumping in, welcome into SFR. This is, of course, Season 4, Round 15 here from the Red Bull Ring in Spielberg, Austria. My name is Kieran Wright 92. I'm joined, as always, on a Saturday night for SFR by the wonderful TES Swayze. We are currently watching a short qualifying session here. Rapid Coot in the McLaren, currently leading the timing screens as it stands. Semper does go with P9 with a 105.222.
I think Big Will is on an improvement lap and for the next car round.
In fact, he's a second up on his time at the moment, is Big Will. So this is the man I've predicted to be top six, and as it stands, he is P6.
104.66 finally from Will. Nice little time.
Gotta love that from Will. So that was the bold prediction I put out in chat, in the stream before we started this qualifying session.
Ryan has hit the track on softs. Just started a flow.
Here we go. Let's see, we've got a yellow flag in sector two. I think that's just gonna be a slow moving Tom Doom. Slow moving Semper. Tom Gorin is on lap. I think Constant Ryan is ahead of him. No. Constant Ryan is not ahead of him, so Tom Gorin was going to be the next person to set a lap time. He is. I'm not sure if that Semper's going to come into the pits. Kirby is way back. Will is going to be doing in lap now. So Tom Gorin is going to be the next man across the line. 8 tenths up, going through. Oh, he's invalidated though. He's gone too far.
Incredible.
On turn eight. He's had a bit of a moment, unfortunately. That is going to be an invalidated lap time for Tom Gorin. Looks like he's potentially setting up to go back to back.
Here we go. What's Ryan going to put in? 1-3-4.
That is a man possessed. Let's go to Christo. On the run up to the line now. SC Christo. Goes P11, 105.168, 0.0001 of a second slower than Tom Gorin for P10.
look how tight it is between Kislesko and T.S. Leclerc at the moment as well.
Yeah, very, very close there between those two. It's what, 400th of a second? 500th of a second. In fact, it's now exactly 500th of a second. I think Kislesko has just slightly, ever so slightly, improved on his previous lap time. He has. 103.742 now for Kislesko, so 500th of a second slower than T.S. Leclerc as it stands. Let's see, Kirby is on a slow lap. Tom Gorion goes P6 with a 103.939. Knocking Big Wall down to P8, which is not good for my prediction.
Or mine. But it's the race where it counts, and as we know, it is. Crazy things do happen.
Cam, 103.2, code pole. Cam has just gone pole, provisional pole, with a 103.251.
There's that. That's,
That is
well,
rapido.
If it's normally anything you can do, I can do as well between Vapid and Cam, and Vapid is out, so.
Vapid crosses the line, 103.4, improves by a tenth of a second.
He didn't have the best exit there in the final, didn't have the best final sector. I think there's more speed in Vapid, yeah.
I could tend to agree with you there. Could most definitely tend to agree with you there. Papa Goose on a medium.
Ryan is back out.
Potentially back out on that. Just Geordie, I think, is the next person that's going to cross the line and set a time on this.
Have a look at him.
Yep, Cam does come into the pits. Let's see what Geordie is able to do. He's 0.05 of a second up. Half a tenth up on his time at the moment.
Okay.
Gets a little bit close to those curves on the exit of the turn.
Using all the track to throw the car into the corner.
Yep, using absolutely every little part of this track that he possibly can. Run up to the line now. Unfortunately, goes slower. The 104.9 for Just Geordie there. Doesn't improve on his 104.762, so he keeps himself in P9 as it stands. Papa Goose is much, much slower, so he is also now...
He's still on a medium tyre.
We've got the man that can only be described as the speed demon himself, Constant Ryan, who...
He's back in.
Interestingly, he's had a bit of a recon lap. I also need to check.
You don't think he's just given up on home with 3 minutes to go, do you? It's not a Ryan thing.
My prediction has gone. Constant Ryan set 2 laps in quali. Boom. Just Geordie, I don't think he's going to be setting another lap.
I think Ryan's going out again. There's no way with 3 minutes left. He's not going to just settle for third, is it?
Yeah, I wouldn't have thought so. I mean, this is Constant Ryan we're talking about here. Just Geordie is looking to go again. Interesting decision here by Just Geordie. Very much doing very much a long out. But we have Kislesko out, we have T.S. Leclerc out, we have Big Will back out, we have Semper back out as well. Here we United see for Prime Minister. Now, guys, let's not go that far.
I mean, yeah, Ryan has just left his box, so he is going back out.
Here we go, ladies and gents. Just Geordie
the
is
final 2 minutes.
Setting a lap time now. As Mr. Swayze did say, we are into the final 2.5 minutes of qualifying here in Austria. The key thing to remember here is, yes, it may be a dry quali, but we have been reliably informed by one of the drivers that it is going to be a wet start to the race.
Even better than that
is okay.
Even better than that though, with the transition from a wet to dry, I do like the transition, because when the transition happens in the race, you know, people do sometimes get it wrong, and going a lap too early or a lap too late can really change things, especially the running order.
Indeed. So Josh Geordie, you may have seen there, guys, did improve on his time at 104.456, now moves himself up to P8. We are riding on board with Kislesko now. We're going to go into broadcast camp. Oh, we've had a spin. Oh, it was the other Red Bull. It's not fair. I almost called it. Josh Geordie went wide into T3. Thought it was Christo. I thought I'd got my second prediction. Kislesko, 103.432. 0.05 of a second slower than Constant Ryan. 0.05 of a second. Kislesko.
He's doing well, Kislesko.
So yes, Leclerc now coming around the final corner.
He's looked tiny this lap.
103.427 replaces Kislesko.
That's exactly the same time as Constant Ryan.
Exactly the same time as Constant Ryan. Gotta see what Mr. Big Will is up to.
It's just purple.
We've got Kirby has invalidated, so we won't be seeing anything else. From
fucking Kirby. Hell, that's fast. Ryan's about to go pole, I think.
103.1 Constant Ryan. 103.1 by Constant Ryan. Jeez! And people ask me why I enjoy SFR as much as I do. This is why, ladies and gents. We have got 12 seconds left.
Vapid,
here
we go.
Here we go. Run up to the line. Vapid improves, but not enough. 103.324 for Vapid Coup as the flag drops. Big Will, no, it's P7. Oh, my prediction was just out. Papa Goose is finishing as well in P10. Let's see, we've got Sir. It's going to be Tom Gorion, who has invalidated, unfortunately. So that's not going to help Tom Gorion's qualifying session. So he's not going to improve. So he's going to, at the moment, stay P6. We'll jump to Just Geordie, who's going to pop into the pits. Christo is going to follow Geordie into the pits as well. That is their qualifying sessions over. Kirby coming round now. Up to the line. Kirby goes P7.
Here comes Cam.
Here comes Cam. I think he might be slower. Cam is slower.
Oh, yeah.
Purposely slows down. I think that could be it. Kislesko's gone 8 tenths slower. So Kislesko's coming
valid.
In. Vapid is also going to be coming in. So that is the end of qualifying. Constant Ryan with a 103.167 takes pole position, and T.S. Leclerc misses out on P3 by 0.02 of a second. 0.02.
That is really tight. I mean, there's only a second from first to eighth.
Yeah, that is insane. For the top eight drivers separated by 1.1, we'll call it, seconds. That is ridiculous, though.
I think the top six, less than 0.2.
We'll have a look for sure when everything has come through. And there we go. So, as you can see, the top five separated by just over a quarter of a second. Constant Ryan is the man on pole position. WRS Cam is in second place with Vapid Coup in third. T.S. Leclerc, Kislesko, Tom Gorion, T.M. Kirby, T.S. Big Will, Just Geordie, and Papa Goose round up your top 10 with SC Christo and Semper HD rounding out the rest of the grid.
Thank you there, T.S. Leclerc.
Thank you.
We have a 21:27 start.
21:27 start, guys. So we've got 3 minutes or so just to get yourselves composed and all of that.
I am waiting to see the next screen, whether it's going to be intermediate, whether it's going to be full wet, because if we've got two transition phases, that's going to be even better.
Damn it, if I'd not invalidated, it would have been pole. Ah, unfortunate, Cam. Unlucky, buddy. You have to get him next time. I'm calling Inter's weather. I don't think that's not wet enough for full wet. I'm going as far as saying Inter's there, Mr. Smith.
I think you may be right.
contract as well.
Doesn't look race stupidly heavy.
Race director is confirming inters on all cars. So it's intermediate weather, guys. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to turn the microphone off for a couple of minutes, guys, just to compose myself. And we will be back in a couple of minutes with the start of the race. So stay tuned. Right, here we go, ladies and gents. We are approaching the final few seconds before the start of this race. We will jump back onto the live screen. Vapid is very excited. Vapid has clearly been doing his rain dances because he's got what he wanted. There is your first ready up from Mr. T.S. Looker and Mr. Papa Goose. Kislesko, TM Kirby and Semper also following suit. So the drivers are going to start readying themselves up. Now, I think there's only one thing that needs to be played as this timer runs down. What needs to be played, you ask? Well, this.
Oh no, my shoes! Okay, mate, we got a few hard ones today. We got Kvyat and the two Willies have gone hard. Everybody else with a free choice is medium, apart from Giovinazzi, who's gone soft.
Thank you for that very precise information, Jarf.
Unfortunately, Jarf, the information you've just given us is wrong, because it's wet, so everyone's on inters.
It's Friday then, it's Saturday, Sunday, what? It's
definitely going to make this race interesting.
Saturday, Sunday, what?
Edge Knight, thank you for the follow. Welcome to SFR. Please enjoy your stay here. Hope you are well. You've had a wonderful, wonderful day so far. And we are glad that you could join us here in a very wet and rainy Austria. So, of course, Mr. Swayze, you have had a lot more experience in the world of Formula One around races in Austria. What are your tips for these drivers, especially in these wet conditions?
I mean, you just got to remember the fact that it's wet. Visuals are going to be a lot lower when you're behind a car, especially the further back you get, the spray is going to be a lot more horrendous than it is the closer you are to the front. Leave a little bit of gap. Don't get yourself that damage. That pit stop is going to cost you more than just taking a few milliseconds off of your lap time to make sure that you're safe.
And I know it's a line that's normally used in Monaco, I think it's only fair that we replace Sandevort with T1. And to any drivers who may be watching and listening, please, no heroics into turn one. We don't want the lap one safety car.
I am stupid.
Hopefully no one says that, F1XL. Hopefully no one says that. No one is quoting Charles Leclerc tonight. I'm sure we will find out very, very soon. You can see the last cars just joining their way up to the track now.
We want some of the... They raced me so hard.
And it's lights out and away we go!
There it is! Lights out and away we go indeed. Oh, we had a look. Someone's having a little bit of a slippy slidey there.
That wine's gone wide. Cam's going to take the lead.
Oh, Kirby's had a spin. Rapid. Kirby has had a spin.
And Leclerc.
Leclerc and Coulson Ryan having a little battle four. Already. Little ding-dong battle. Coulson Ryan has not had a good start to this race. Cam takes the early lead. Vapakoot in second. Coulson Ryan now down to third.
Yeah, he's just took it back. He was looking at a possible first to fourth for the Slen in the opening two corners. But looking at enough, we seem to have got all the corners away quite well.
Ooh, the big Will has left the session. Swayze, do you want to just shoot an invite back over to Will so we can get Will back into the lobby? We get the first few laps underway. We've got Mr. Peewee in the chat. How you doing, Peewee? Hope you're well, buddy. Welcome in. So WRS Cam does lead as we approach the end of lap 1 of 36 here in Austria. Vapakoot behind him in second place for the McLaren team with our pole sitter. Constant Ryan currently sitting in third. TS Leclerc in fourth. Just Geordie up to fifth.
Is Lesko still holding on strong as well?
Ooh, Semper and Big Will both in the pit.
What has gone on with Vapid? Why is Vapid all the way down in seventh?
I think it's a timing glitch, I'm not gonna lie. Thank you, G.
Oh, that's hurt. Thank God. Thank God for that.
Yeah, there we go. It is the timing glitch. So we have got Semper and Big Will who have both come in.
Should have known better.
Wings. So we'll go back through what we had. TS Leclerc is in fourth place at the moment. Kislesko is in fifth. Tom Gorian in sixth.
In fact, looking to someone on Kislesko.
A little bit of a battle here. And could open the door for Just Geordie. But Kislesko is able to defend from Just Geordie and looks to try and potentially mount an offense on Tom Gorian again.
Nice move by Tom Gorian there, of course. There's going to be no DRS while it's raining.
Indeed, no DRS.
All of this is on.
All done on four drivers.
So it's like Kislesko is coming back.
There it is, we saw it from Tom Gorian on board. Up the inside.
Did I go for it? Did I send it? Or did I not? Didn't send it?
Yeah, you
did. Oh, send
what a battle we've got already between these two.
That was fantastically timed by Stowell, who plays the Carlos Sainz. Did I send it? Or did I not? Didn't send it? As Papa Goose and Just Geordie having a battle as well. Just Geordie has to have a 3-second time penalty, though. Four multiple warnings. We are on lap three now. Cam still leads the race. Vapakoot in second. Cam has pulled out nearly a second lead over Vapakoot already. He's lingering around that 8-tenths mark at the moment.
Tom Gordon is going to send one again.
We're going to have a send it. We have got a send it. Switchback potential? No. Well defended by Tom Gordon. That is Tom Gordon up to P5. Got a funny feeling, Swayze. This is going to be one of the main battles to watch as this race progresses.
Well, we'll see whether Kislesko can do the same thing he did and send one back again.
Just Geordie, who is looking to get a little bit close to Papa Goose, trying to put the horse driver under a little bit of pressure. Unable to get any movements done just yet. This is your battle for P7, as that's the Cooper puts in the horse for that. Of the Grand Prix, the 114.32.
He's right there on the back of Cam.
And have a nosy at the battle at the front. The battle further down looks to potentially dive down. In fact, saying that, Christo could be getting himself involved in the little battle between Just Geordie and Papa Goose. My partner is sending me 8 million messages whilst I'm trying to commentate. He's doing that for me this time.
And Christo not far now from the back of Geordie. Kislesko still trying his best to hang on to Tom Gorian. Vapid all over the back of Cam are the main battles at the moment.
That is going to be your main battle at the moment. Tom Gorian is pulling out about a second's gap now to Kislesko. Josh Geordie is lingering around that 6-tenth mark. Away from Papa.
Lap is cute, going purple there behind Cam.
Half a second back from Cam in the Mercedes. Obviously no DRS because of the wet weather condition. Constant Ryan 14-1. Just doing constant Ryan things, innit?
They're exchanging them at the moment between the top three. I mean, Ryan's just as close to Vapid as what Vapid is to Cam, so, you know, anything can happen between the top three at the moment.
Good indeed. Semper picks up a 3-second time penalty as well for multiple warnings, which is not ideal for the young Welshman. Hopefully we will see something a little bit better from Semper as this race progresses. We are watching this battle for P1 as it stands. Vapid Coup hunting down WRS Cam. You see the telemetry there on screen as well. You see how much ERS usage, obviously in wet conditions, is a lot easier to save that ERS. The ERS will regenerate a hell of a lot quicker if you are breaking earlier.
I don't really necessarily know about that. I mean, you tend to need to use it more, especially if you're in the pack and you're trying to work your way through, because it's your only really valid way of trying to make an overtake. Because with DRS being disabled, you're going to have to rely on ERS more to make the overtake.
Yeah, from my personal experience anyway, I always tend to regenerate a lot more ERS on the braking in wet conditions than I do in dry.
Maybe because the braking zones are extended, because you brake a little bit earlier, so you're on the brakes for longer.
Still no one looking to make moves just yet. Alberto Cam does still lead the Grand Prix, led from turn one, but a very, very early jump on Constant Ryan. Pushed Constant Ryan down.
Just Jordy, though. It is. Oh, is he? Oh, he had it before about it for a minute. He's right there on that Papa Goose now.
There we go, you can see it here. So, as just mentioned, just Geordie, the debutant, battling the other debutant we have here in SFR. Two new drivers battling it out through the Styrian Hills. Papa Goose
looking
there.
Twitchy. Ooh, there.
Big wheel! No, Will! Will! No! Turn 3 has claimed his first victim.
And it's not good. Just Geordie getting a kick there. That's going to give Christo a chance to try and close the gap a little bit more.
See,
he's just falling back a little bit.
Has Will just Magnussen? I genuinely
have no
think
idea.
Will has actually just Magnussen. Because he is pretty far way back in turn 3 then. Hopefully everything's all right with Will. Hopefully the game hasn't
turned
him over.
Come on, Rapid is right there.
That's so close to Cam though now. Josh Geordie does make that move on Papa Goose. Now we've got a yellow flag.
Oh, we have a yellow flag because it has gone. Papa Goose has gone.
Oh, it's Papa Goose. He's out of spin. I think Josh Geordie's also had a bit of a... They had a moment.
I wonder whether there was a contact, because
no
just Geordie
on
was obviously right there with him.
There's no contact, there's no damage on Geordie's car, but Papa Goose is completely missing a front wing. There's absolutely zero front wing on the car of Papa Goose.
I have no idea what happened there. We can all but speculate. Let's see, yes, Leclerc sets the fastest lap.
Now 6 tenths away. Constant Ryan, though, within half a second of Vapid Coupe, the man who started this race on pole position, fell down a couple of positions early on in the race. So he's looking to try and see if he can get himself.
Oh no, my shoes! Okay, mate, we got a few hard ones today. We got Kvyat and the two Willies have gone hard. Everybody else with a free choice is
Kirby
medium, apart from Giovinazzi, who's gone soft.
Thank you for the very precise information, Geoff.
Jarvis, the wrong information. Crying out loud. So thank you for playing the Ono machine. Big Will's in chat. I am fucking done, man. Will, what happened, bro? What happened, my dude? Will, if you feel like jumping in on comms, you are more than welcome.
You're more than welcome to Yeah, I mean, we don't... Yeah, please, come in. Fill us in. What happened? We don't know. We missed it.
If you would like, my friends, completely up to you, of course. I genuinely hear my laptop getting ready to take off.
You can blame us. I mean, we may have commented and cursed you. Yeah, that is a plausible option.
We may or may not have put some pretty bold statements out before Philly. In terms of your performance, we may have potentially cursed you, I'm not going to lie. Cam is now within Vapid is within 4/10 of Cam. And is it me, Swears, or is it stopped raining?
It does look that way. It is getting... There's definitely a drier line, isn't there?
A drier line starting to form on this track.
I don't think there's any raindrops coming down, so...
See whether Vapid can get ahead of Cam now. And those Cam is a very, very strong defensive driver. Showcased that pretty well in Bahrain. You guys do remember that a couple of weeks ago. Cam was very, very good defending against SF1 Harrison. Of course, raced in that race a couple of weeks ago. As you know, Harrison tonight. But say that Vapid gets to within a quarter of a second of Cam in sector 2. And then through sector 3 seems to lose that time. But that gap now is back up to 6.5 tenths. Just dips under that now as Vapid gets into the slipstream of Cam.
You got a lot better exit going up the hill there, didn't you, Vapid?
He's got a much better exit, getting a lot closer now. He is a lot closer to Cam now, not close enough to make a move just yet, though.
Ryan gets a little twinge.
Nothing doing just yet.
This is going to be so important for these drivers, especially further back, as it gets drier, to get the changeover right.
Yep, you don't want to go too early. Obviously, you go too early, and it will come back to haunt you, but of course, the tyres will just...
You can see there on the broadcast camera just how much spray there still actually is coming off the track. So I don't think we're ready yet, but I feel it might be maybe pushing about 6 to 7 laps, and we probably will be.
Let's see, Constant Ryan, he is at the back of this little battle between Cam and Vapid, getting himself involved in the battle now, as well as TS Leclerc, who's about 7 tenths further back. That's a very, very strong exit there by Constant Ryan. Is he going to finally be able to get that run on Vapid Coot up the hill towards turn 3? Vapid Coot pulls to the right, defends that inside line. Is Constant Ryan going to look to send one? Decides that discretion is the best part of valor there. As Kislesko comes into the pits and goes on mediums. That, I think, Sways, is maybe a little bit too early.
I feel you may be right, but we will find out. He's going to be the guinea pig for the pack. Big slides on the exit of the pit.
Well, that's going to be the thing to watch now, guys. Watch that gap between Kislesko and TM Kirby. If that comes down very, very quickly, expect to see cars come into the pits for slick tyres. I genuinely don't think that it is...
This climb is building fast.
Yeah, 7.4,
7.5.
I really don't think it's dry enough yet. The top three have not done it. Woo, Jamie has a bit of a moment there. TS Leclerc has a little bit of a moment. They're coming out of the penultimate corner. Holds onto it, though, so it's not too bad. Just Jordy has now taken Kislesko. You can watch when Kislesko's on board. He is really, really struggling, having to take turns 6 and 7, at fourth gear.
You still see the shine
around
on the tyres, how wet they are.
It was a risk from Kislesko, and unfortunately it's not worked for him.
And I think it's going to lose him some severe time to Tom Gorman.
And still holds on to the lead, though. We are 11 laps gone, so we're on lap 12 here in Austria, a third of the way through this Grand Prix now. This is round 15 of season 4.
He's really starting to reel in Christo at the moment.
He is indeed. 8 tenths is now the gap between Kirby and Christo, just dipping into that 9 tenths mark, back down, back up to the second.
I just jumped on board with Jamie and he's having a brown trouser moment.
Let's see what happens here. We're going to watch from TS in the first position as he comes round the final corner now. On the run up to the line, it's not close enough to make any moves.
It's getting
Ryan just yet.
Very close. The track looks very dry now.
I think maybe another couple of laps just to remove these last few bits of spray that we are currently getting on track. And I wouldn't be surprised if you see these guys start coming in for slick tyres. Because Lesko picked up a 3 second time penalty as Ryan locks up under braking into turn three.
You see, that was on board because Lesko, what happened is he put the power down and it just pushed him wide onto the curb. He had no choice but to let it go, to, otherwise it was going. He is in fact now boxing. I think, is he coming off of the mediums? Back onto inters?
Jordy is coming off and putting, Josh Jordy has put mediums on. Because Lesko is coming in and putting inters back on.
This is interesting now then, because you've got one and one, because these two are actually, well, the, not those two, I mean, Tom Gorin was in the fight with Thingy, but we've got one driver obviously thinking, okay, it's time to go, and the other one going, now I've had enough of that, and going back onto the inters. So,
indeed, we shall see. Vapid is a lot closer to Cam now. He's been able to drop Constant Ryan just a little bit. Is he going to look to potentially make a move into turn one? Doesn't do it yet. There's turn one, and we've got the little kink, which is technically a turn here in Austria, just up here. This is turn two on the run up to turn three. Is Vapid going to try and line up and move on Cam now? Again, not just yet.
Looking to get the better exit.
You know what? I think he has. I genuinely think he has, Swayze. Cam's doing a little bit of wiggle trying to break that toe, but is unable to break it. Vapid's going to go up the inside of Cam. Is he going to be able to stick it in there? That's so close. That is so close.
Cam got the better exit.
Cam's just got
though.
It. Has he got it though? Vapid potentially going to go around the outside of Tom, of Cam. Is going to work? No, it's not. Ooh, that's close. That was close.
That was some amazing racing between Cam and Vapid there.
Fantastic.
Whoa, there. Cam gets a bit of snap there.
He did, and that's going to open the door for Vapid now through turns 9 and 10.
Oh, ooh, it's a great
Cam
whoa,
dives in. Cam was... dives in. Cam has dove but into not, the pits.
Yes, but will he be penalised for that? Because was that not, you did not state, that was not from within the left side.
He didn't state his intentions clearly enough. He has gone onto the medium tyres. That is going to be something for the stewards to potentially have a look at post-race. I will leave that up to them though. Obviously, won't comment too much on that at the moment. Tom Gorin is also into the pits, coming in for slick tyres. Christo picks up a 3 second time penalty. I think now, Swayze, we have reached our crossover point. We are at the crossover
we
point.
Are getting the spray out. Doesn't look like there's any coming off now when you're on broadcast. I think that's just oil that you can see there coming out the back of the cars. I suspect the top three will dive in.
We shall see. Vapid, who currently leads the Grand Prix. We've got a yellow flag in sector three. It's Jordy. He's ended up in, I don't think, he's had a spin out of turn eight, potentially. He's going to get lapped by the leaders. We'll just watch now. Vapid 2 does not come in. Constant Ryan doesn't come in. Jamie does not come in. Top three have not come in yet. They do not think that it is right for slick tyres just yet. Oh, we've lost Just Jordy. We have lost Just Jordy.
They will come in now.
Full course safety car has indeed come out. I don't think we've got anyone that is on a... Oh, Kirby is pretty much a lap down, so Kirby is going to hug that inside line. This is the line that drivers should be taking to enter the pits. Christo has also done the same thing. But these two drivers are going to come in. Expect to see slick tyres go onto these two cars. Watch now, Vapid, Poot, Constant Ryan, and TAS Leclerc. Surely these guys have got to come in now, so it's surely under this safety.
Yeah. You'd think so.
The medium tyres going onto both Kirby and Christos' cars there. Let's see where Semper HD is. Semper HD uses the correct line. Well done, Semper.
As does Kislesko.
Papa Goose is a few corners back.
So that leaves our leaders, are they going in?
Vapid very much hugging that inside line. Vapid has declared his intentions very, very clearly, as has Constant Ryan, as has Leclerc. All three are coming into the pit now. Papa Goose is...
Where is Cam?
That is an interesting decision by Papa Goose to stay out on those intermediate tyres.
Yeah, I would have thought he would have took the pit, especially under the safety car conditions.
Yeah. Interesting. The guys are starting to come out now. Vapid has...
Christo picked up a drive-through penalty for speeding under the safety car.
He has indeed, I think. Cam and Leclerc are literally inside each other there. Oh, Cam picked up a 3 second.
He did, but worse than that...
Worst of all,
the fact that they got under safety car, yeah, he dropped from first to fourth.
Overcut has worked for the top three cars. I think the WRS Cam maybe came in a little bit too early on those slick tyres.
I don't think it was that. I think it was literally one lap after the fact, after he pit the safety car. And yeah, the safety car is going to... The Delta would have stopped, would have prevented Cam from using his undercut.
Too much, yeah. It's interesting to see now whether Papa Goose does come into the pits now. Maybe he's the only car currently out on track on those intermediate tyres. Surely those tyres have got to be overheating now. He does come down the inside now. He is going to mark his intention to come into the pits. He does indeed do so. So we are now under...
It'll be called onto the slicks now, then.
It's going to be from medium tyres, I would have thought, go onto your Papa Goose's car. Watch to see what goes onto the Haas. Cam now dives into the pit. Papa Goose has indeed put medium tyres on. Cam dives into the pit.
Wow.
Fresh set of
wing damage.
Fresh set of mediums.
No set of mediums.
Fresh set of mediums going onto Cam's car there. Very, very interesting decision there from Cam. I wouldn't have thought those tyres would be that warm. Because, as you said, they were only a lap older than the other guys.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's a very weird thing to happen.
Very, very interesting decision there. We are under safety car conditions here in Austria, lap 18. Of 36. This is, of course, round 15 of SFR Season 4. My name is Kieran, right now, to joined by TES Swayze. Hope you guys are enjoying the broadcast this evening. If this is your first time watching SFR and you are enjoying what you see, please consider dropping a follow on the channel. We have recently hit 150 followers on the channel, and our goal is to try and hit 200 by the end of the summer. Well, that is the goal here for SFR. And of course, if you have got Twitch Prime, please do consider dropping your Twitch Prime subscription on SFR. It does help the channel out massively. And we are in the process of trying to get some emotes and things done so you guys can drop SFR style emotes in chats with your subscriber. But so stay tuned for those. Hopefully they will come sooner rather than later. But yeah, please consider dropping your subscription, your Prime sub on SFR. It would be greatly, greatly appreciated from all of us here at Supreme Racing. We are still partway through a little bit of a channel rebrand in some way. We are improving daily, we're improving weekly here in SFR, trying to get new things done. We are expanding our horizons as well. Of course, we have got the new SFR ACC League on Assetto Corsa Competizione, hopefully starting in the next couple of weeks or so. So please do stay tuned for that if you guys are interested in getting involved and joining the SFR community. Discord link and just post the chat now. Give me just a second.
Right there on your side of your screen in the chat box. Safety car is in this lap. We will be going racing again. Vapid Coot to be our safety car as he lets the safety car pull away.
There is the SFR Discord just popped in chat there, guys. If you are watching and would like to be involved in the racing side of things here in SFR, please do consider jumping over and joining the Discord, joining the driver sign up sheets that we have got available on the Discord, and get yourselves into the action. As Slazy did say, safety car is coming in. Vapid Coot does pace the field and goes really, really early. Slazy, Constant Ryan wasn't ready for that on the run into T9.
Good job.
Vapid goes very, very early. Constant Ryan now is able to try and catch back up to Vapid. But we are back under green flag conditions. We are racing once again here. And Cam
has got past Kirby.
On Kirby very, very early on after the safety car restart.
You know, he'll want to get so straight back onto the back of Leclerc, you know he will.
As Kislesko makes a move on Semper as well. Kislesko now up to P8. Of course, Kislesko was the initial guinea pig when it came to the running of the slick tyres. Goes deep into T3. Chance for Semper to potentially come back, but isn't able to do anything just yet. Cam, though, getting close to Tom Gorion. Partial send it there from WRS.
Didn't take him long.
It's not taking them long at all to get up back up onto the backs of the four lead cars here in this Austrian Grand Prix.
Of course, now we are on the slick tyre. DRS will be active in, roughly, I'm going to guess, about 3 laps time. Lap 23, lap 22. Whoa! Ooh. Big bunch of curb there for Cam.
Yeah, saw that. Woo. Kirby picked up a 3 second time penalty. I believe the safety car came in on lap 20. So 21, 22, 23 it should be. We get DRS enabled.
Kirby is coming back at Krista.
Is coming onto Tom Gorion now. Up the inside into T3. Fantastic move there by WRS Cam. Moving himself up.
Kirby gets the move done.
P4 as Kirby makes that move on Christo, and that is TM Kirby up into P6. But
Christo's gonna send one back.
Christo gonna look to try and do it around the outside, not able to do it.
Of course, Christo has a drive through penalty, he does have to serve within 3 laps. That safety car ending. Kislesko closing right in on the back of these two now as well.
Yeah, he is indeed. Christo has got a couple of laps left to serve that drive through, otherwise he will be in a lot of trouble. Kislesko, as you can see though, from the rear view there. He's not going to do it yet. Christo runs really, really wide and open the door for Kislesko. There's a little bit of a twitch on the exit there, does Kislesko, but he's able to hold on to it. And there it is. There is the confirmation. Christo did not serve that drive-through penalty within 3 laps.
I think, of course, there was a car on the inside of him there. Maybe he couldn't have got into the white line in time and he thought he'd be in trouble, so he couldn't have swung across from where he was.
It's a little bit harsh there on Christo. I'm sure Christo will probably jump into the chat and have a chat with the guys in chat when he does come through. Unfortunately, that is a disqualification for Christo, so that's Christo's race over after 21 laps of racing here in Austria. Vapid Coot does lead your Grand Prix, nearly second ahead of Constant Ryan. That all-important second gap looks to potentially almost be bridged, giving Vapid Coot the relaxation of not having to worry too much about DRS. I haven't had the notification that DRS has been re-enabled yet.
It definitely is, though.
It has definitely been enabled, though. Kozlesko, 3 second time penalty. You can see Constant Ryan has got DRS, as does the player.
Kozlesko on Kerber, making a move up the hill.
There it is, you see the move made just there by Kozlesko. That's Kozlesko now up into P6.
Kerber now with the DRS.
Yeah, we're going to look to try and see if Sam can get onto the back of this battle as well. Is Kirby going to get the move done on Kozlesko?
Switch back.
No, very well defended there by Kozlesko. In the
nice
Mercedes,
driving, yeah.
Very, very nice driving there by Kozlesko. Hold onto that P6. As Cam picks up another 3 second time penalty. Let's kind of look at the penalty situation at the moment as it stands. Cam and Kozlesko both on 6 seconds. Kirby, Semper and Papakos all on 3. The other five driver, the other four drivers, sorry, yet to see fastest laps are being exchanged multiple times by drivers. Currently being held by, I believe it is Cam. It is indeed Cam, 107.754 by WRF Cam. Currently is the fastest lap of the Grand Prix. Kirby not close enough to get the move done. On Kozlesko up into T3.
Oh,
Kirby's had a big moment on the exit of turn 3 there. Big,
Ooh. Gonna need some toilet paper after that one.
I think that, ladies and gents, is what T.S. Swayze calls a brown trouser moment.
Almost definitely.
That was a very big brown trouser moment there from T.M. Kirby. Papakos does still lead this Grand Prix. But Constant Ryan within half a second now. He has got that DRS. Leclerc goes fast as a 107.531. That is your fastest lap of the Grand Prix so far. Semper picks up a 3 second time penalty for multiple warnings. Ryan not close enough yet to Vapid to be able to make that move stick.
Kozlesko seems to bridge the gap now to Kerber after that moment.
These guys are battling. It opens the door for TES Leclerc to eventually get him get himself involved in the battle as well. So it's definitely worth keeping an eye on. And Cam is only 8.5 tenths behind Leclerc. So don't count Cam out just yet, ladies and gents. Do not count WRS Cam out just yet. He is a very, very apt racer. I'm sure he'll be very, very much wanting to be a part of this battle. As you can see now, these guys are so, so close to each other. Again, exchanging fastest laps. Cam, just shy of a 106 at the moment. I've been getting a really, really good exit though. If Cam picks up another 3 second time penalty, but Constant Ryan, there we go, makes the move on Vapid. Is he going to be able to hold it? Leclerc potentially going to get involved in the battle as well. We're going to jump to the onboard with Leclerc. Is he going to be able to potentially look and make a move on these front two? Vapid is going to look to make the move back on Constant Ryan into turn 4. Not able to make that move just yet. Constant Ryan does now once again lead the Grand Prix. The man who started this race on pole position is now back in the lead of this Grand Prix. What we'll do is we'll have a quick look at the position changes so you guys can see what has happened so far. So Vapid and TS Leclerc up 1, Cam is down 2, Tom Gorin is up 1, Kozlesko is down 1, Kirby has stayed where he is, Semper and Papakos are both up 4 and 1 respectively. As Constant Ryan hits a 106.650, we have now dipped into the 106s in terms of lap times. Expect these lap times to just get quicker as the race progresses. Tom Gorian now picks up his first 3 second time penalty of the evening, meaning just the top three drivers are the only ones without time penalties as it stands as we are on lap number 27 of 36 here in Austria. Constant Ryan leads the Grand Prix. Vapakou in second place. TS Leclerc currently in third. Cam just over half a second back from Leclerc and this podium. But A key thing to note is that WRS Cam does have 9 seconds worth of penalties. As it stands, Cam will only, he'll only put one position as it stands because of the gap between Tom Gorian and Kislezka. Oh, we've lost Papa Goose from the session. That is not ideal.
That is unfortunate.
Bear with me a second, guys. I'm just going to try and see if I can get him back into the into the game if need be.
Leclerc is right there on the back of Vapid at the moment. I'm watching on board from Vapid for the last few laps. He's just managing to maintain the DRS gap to Constant Ryan, but you can see the speed in that Williams driver. Unbelievable at the moment.
Leclerc's starting to pull out a bit more of a gap over Cam now. The gap is now nearly 8 tenths of a second between Leclerc and Cam. That was at one point closer to about 3 or 4 tenths. Tom Goose has joined us once again, so hopefully he'll be able to get control of his car very, very quickly and get himself back into racing with that pass. Currently down in ninth place, so he's looking to get points on debut, which is
All he has to do is finish.
106.5 by Constant Ryan, currently fastest lap of the Grand Prix so far. You know what, Swayze? I'm going to say a bold statement right now. Leclerc is more likely to overtake Vapid than Vapid is to overtake Constant Ryan.
Yeah, I can see that. But none of them have got much ERS at all, that's for sure.
No, out of the top three, Constant Ryan has got the best full number of ERS. He has 22% of his ERS still left in his battery. Vapid down to 17, and Leclerc just done a little bit of saving now.
The top three, Ryan's the only one who doesn't get DRS as well, though.
Indeed.
It is not stopping him maintaining that lead at the moment since he got it. He's doing just enough to, as I say, Rapid bringing it back down from about 7 tenths in these 3 DRS zones. And then he's just doing just enough to make him bridge that, hold the gap, because Ryan's so fast on the exits, he's just building that gap straight back up to about 7 and 8 tenths. And if Vapid slips once and falls out of DRS, you're right, Jamie, he's got a bigger threat from Jamie.
Semper in the pit, so I'm wondering whether this is going to be Semper going onto soft tyres to try and get past his lap. Let's have a look. And it is, it's soft tyres going onto that racing point car there of Semper HD. He's going to look to try and see if he can get that fastest lap of the Grand Prix. Get that all important extra point. We shall see. But as Swayze said, Constant Ryan doing so well at defending. This is similar to the job that T.S. Leclerc did in Brazil, if you remember, Swayze. It's of course available on the SFR YouTube channel, youtube.com, and search for Supreme Formula Racing. We are on the hunt for 100 subscribers as well on the YouTube channel, guys. Can get ourselves up to 100 subscribers on the YouTube channel, we will be able to get our own custom URL and make it a lot easier for you guys to be able to search for Supreme Formula Racing. And as soon as this race is finished, I myself will be personally uploading this entire stream onto the SFR YouTube channel, and that's where these races will stay forever now. After every single race in SFR, it will be uploaded onto the YouTube channel for you guys to be able to continue watching. As Kislesko's getting very, very close to Tom Gorian now. He's going to look potentially up for a move down the inside of Turn 4. Tom Gorian is just able to hold on to it for now, though.
Speaking of getting close, Vapid is closing that gap. I mean, I'm going to have to eat my own words at the moment, because he really is pulling that gap back down before DRS this time. So I expect to see him within 2 tenths.
Tom Gorian picks up another 3 second tyre penalty.
And there you go, look, Vapid Coop, fast, that's what I'm saying, like, he's pulling in, look.
There it is. regardless, but it's going to get DRS on Tom Gorin though on the 1-2-T1. No move able to be made by the Mercedes driver, but we're going to jump up the back of Coot now. He's going to look to potentially get the better exit from Constant Ryan at the exit of turn three. Constant Ryan just drives away though, but he has got DRS now, has Vapid. The McLaren driver pulls to the right. Is he going to look to remove down the inside? Decides against it. Big lock up there though by Constant Ryan. As Tom Gorin and Keselowski's battle between each other for positions here. I think it's Tom Gorin does get DRS from turn three to turn four, so he's able to hold on to that fifth place as it stands. But he has got Kislesko all over the back of him. These two are really, really battling with each other. They expect to see this battle go until the very, very end. Constant Ryan now pulling out a 7/10 of a second lead over Vapid Coot. Tom Gorin does give the position away to Kislesko, but it was potentially a bit of a master play by Tom Gorin, because of course he's giving Kislesko the position, which allows Tom Gorin DRS on the Mercedes driver now up the hill.
Look at the exit speed of Kislesko though up the hill.
Here we go, Tom Gorin pulls to the left and makes that move on Kislesko, but of course that is now going to open the door for Kislesko to now get DRS back on Tom Gorin in the racing point. These guys are going to be having a ding-dong battle all the way through to the end of this race. Expect to see these guys chop and change position quite a few times now. Between now and the end of the race, Kislesko now gets the move done on Tom Gorin, but for how long? He's able to hold it now for the double left-hander. So for now at least, Kislesko has E5. We will definitely keep an eye on that battle.
Ryan is so fast in section three.
Three laps to go. 34, 35, 36. That is all we have got left.
Do you see any position changes, Kieran? You think we're going to finish as is between the top three?
I think top three. You know what? I can't see a move. I'm going to be honest. I can't see a move made.
I'm going to have to agree.
Very good driver. All three of them are very, very good. Very, very competent drivers. Oh,
Tom Gorin just got past Kislesko.
Here we go. As we said, these guys are going to be battling left and right. We're going to be going on board now with Kislesko, who's going to make that move without DRS, interestingly. Around the inside of Tom Gorin. Is Tom Gorin going to be able to hold it out there, though? These guys are still side by side going into double left-hander. Tom Gorin does just get ahead of Kislesko, but these guys are still side by side with one another. But no move able to be made just yet, but we're going to jump back in now and watch. Can Tom Gorin pull away from Kislesko on the main straight? Bastion, what are you doing? You're supposed to be concentrating on the race, not sending messages in the blooming chat. On this Stemba HD, our current P9, ladies and gentlemen, in chat, informing us all that he has got the fastest lap, which is something we knew anyway. He is on the soft tyre, but it is somewhat to be expected. He is on the fastest tyre. He simply picked up another 3-second time penalty. See, that's what happens, Stempa, when you start typing in chat instead of concentrating on your race, young man. The 105.745 is currently your fastest lap of the Grand Prix, set by Stempa HD. That is your penalty situation. 12 seconds for Stempa, 3 apiece for Kirby and Papa Goose, 6 apiece for Kislesko and Tom Gorin, and 9 for WRS Cam.
But no laps left for Vapid Coot. They are on their last lap, and if he wants that race win, he's going to have to do it on this lap. There's a big moment there, and I think that's just cost him it.
The most important thing to note here as well, Swayze, is Leclerc is outside of DRS.
Yeah.
Leclerc is outside of DRS range. I think, ladies and gents, that's going to be it.
At the top of the hill, Vapid had a moment on the exit of three, and it cost him the gap.
think Constant Riot is going to be the man that takes the checkered flag here in Austria. We're going to ride on board with Constant Riot as he takes these final few turns. We will let Mr. Swayze have a watch of that battle between Tom Gorey and Ads Kizilesko as these guys are still exchanging positions. But it is Constant Ryan, the man on pole, crosses the line to win the Austrian Grand Prix. Vapid Coupe does finish in second place with T.S. Leclerc finishing in third. Cam, despite his penalties, will stay in fourth position. Tom Gorey and Kizilesko, this is a battle for position. They both have the same amount of penalties.
Oh, moment there for
Tom Gorey is going to hold on. Tom Gorey takes P5. Kizilesko takes P6. Kirby up to the line now to take P7. Papa Goose is going to come around the final corner now on debut to pick up an eighth place. He's going to pick himself up 4 points in the championship. Massive, massive congratulations there to Papa Goose for that eighth place on debut. And Semper HD is just going to coast across the line in normal Semper HD fashion. In fact, he's not.
Stop.
There we go. Now he crosses the line.
Just to prove you wrong. Just to prove you wrong.
Really, Semper, you had to do that. The annoying pain.
There was that one, isn't there?
So somehow, driver of the day goes to Semper. Ninth to 12th to 9th with 12 seconds worth of penalties and a fastest lap. So that is the driver of the day to Semper HD. But,
and that right there shows you how broken Codemasters is.
Indeed. Well, we will go. We'll ask you, Sway. Who's your driver of the day?
I mean, it's got to be Ryan. I mean, he was first. He had the worst start. He maintained composure, managed to bring it back, got in front of Vapid when he needed to, and then did absolutely superb to hold it. So, you know, it's got to be Constant Ryan for me.
There we go. Constant Ryan does pick up driver of the day from TES Swayze. What we're going to do, ladies and gents, is just going to quickly pop the... So that is your driver's standings there, guys. Constant Ryan with a win. Vapid Coupe in second. T.S. Leclerc in third, Cam in fourth, Tom Gorey in fifth, Kizilesko in sixth, Team Kirby in seventh, Papa Goose in eighth, Semper in ninth, Christo unfortunately disqualified, finishing in tenth with Just Jordy and T.S. Big Will as your DNFers. We're going to jump over to the intro screen there just so you can see that for just a second, guys. We're going to get the guys into a party. Just bear with us just a second, ladies and gents. We will get the podium places into the party, and then we will do something else that needs to be done, something else that is new, or well, returning I should say, to and there is Constant Ryan joining as well. So we've got the gentleman just joining the party now. Here we go. The gentlemen are all joining us now. First things first, we have got something that we've not done for a while here in SFR, but we will be bringing it back. So just bear with me just a second, guys, as we will be playing the national anthem of our race winner, Constant Ryan, and of course the Constructors national anthem, which of course is the national anthem of Great Britain for the Williams team, providing everything needs to work properly at my end, which knowing my luck, it's probably not going to. But
next
we shall
question, are you
going
to get it in the right order?
I should be able to get it in the right order. We shall just make sure it actually works first. Beep-a-doop-a-doop. Come on.
Yeah.
national anthems of the Republic of Ireland and, of course, Great Britain.
Pepper, stay focused. What is it? Pepper, stay focused.
I am focused.
Please.
I am focused, don't worry.
I am focused, don't worry. So we will speak with our podium places, starting off with the man who finishes in third place. The man who has just posted that sound clip in chat, Mr. T.S. Leclerc. Jamie, how are you doing, buddy?
Good evening, guys. How are we all?
Not too bad, not too bad, mate. Talk us through your race.
Qualifying, I was kind of happy with because I never really had pace here at Austria. Went with the dry setup, which was a risk, which is why I nearly died about three times in the wet. But I felt like I actually had good pace in the wet. Fastest guy on track at that point. So was happy with my pace in the wet, and then Vafford just about stayed in DRS to Constant Ryan, so I couldn't really go for a move. I felt like I had decent race pace then, so on another day it could have been completely different, but I'll take P3. When Cam boxed for mediums, I knew it was too early. As the safety car came out, I was like, right, now we can pit. And didn't lose any time to Cam, and to add insult to injury for Cam, he picked up a penalty trying to drive too fast to get past us three that just come out the pit lane. Is why you can never trust Jeff, I guess.
So obviously when that safety car came out, the thought was always, right, now's when I'm coming in for slicks.
It was going to be that lap anyway. So yeah, always in my mind to box for the slicks, and it was always going to be the mediums because they would have easily gone to the end from there. I'm sorry to do this, Cam, but to add even more insult to injury, you are getting a massive penalty. He overtook before the line.
Oh. Oh dear.
So, yeah, that's caught from my POV as well. So, unluckily for Cam, you were even on board with him at the time. He saw what happened at Mexico with Christo. Unfortunately, that's going to happen to Cam as well, which is annoying because he had good pace here today. He just messed his own strategy up.
Yeah, but also a bit of bad luck there as well, pitting one lap before the safety car.
Yeah, he's and in then, trouble for the pit entry as well. So it's not his weekend. We put it in the driver's briefing. It just proved the people that read it and the people that didn't. So, I mean, we've got to be harsh to stop these things happening. People might not like it, but rules are rules at the end of the day. Indeed. Sorry to go all league owner.
No, you are more than welcome to do so much. So there we go. T.S. Leclerc laying out the law. The drivers were aware, and I did, of course, mention it as we were getting ready to start the race, as the drivers were finishing their formation laps. They needed to observe the correct etiquette whilst entering the pits. Unfortunately, as you saw with some of the incidents, and as Jamie did just mention, unfortunately, that wasn't the case in terms of Cam. So, of course, a retrospective punishment there will most likely be coming his way. But, of course, I will leave that to the stewards in SFR to decide what happens there. But we will comment on next week for you, Jamie. Hungary, a track I know that you are very, very familiar with, having raced it quite a few times in the last month or so. This will be the third time in about 6 weeks or so that you have raced Hungary. In fact, no, fourth time in about 6 weeks that you've raced Hungary. How are you feeling?
Still better than Vietnam, though. I'm feeling all right, to be honest. Previous other leagues, I've seemed to do well there. Particularly the late night one where I went from the back to the podium, so if I can replicate something like that again, then bring it on. We should have a lot more drivers next week as well. Obviously, it was payday yesterday. It's bank holiday weekend. People are out and about. We get it. So we are going to have races where we are struggling. But I think me and Moore will come to the conclusion, because obviously there's a massive championship fight. I'm included in that championship, I think. I know I'm not close, but I'm still mathematically in it, I think. I'm sure Vafid and Shane will turn up each week. And if we get 9 races, I mean, there's usually action up and down the field anyway. I'm sure they'd want to just carry on battling it out for the championship and that top prize, essentially. So, yeah, it's a difficult time for us, but we get why it's happening. It's the end of this game cycle, so we just have to suck it up, unfortunately, and come back stronger in the new game.
Indeed, we will. But hopefully the guys that have raced today and the guys who are, of course, associated with SFR do still stick with us for the remaining 5 races that we do have left on this season, and we round out this season in a very, very nice, strong, competitive way. But congratulations to you, Jamie, on that P3. We will now move on to our second place driver, the McLaren driver of Mr. Vapid Coup. Welcome once again to the post-race interviews. How are you doing, my friend?
Hey, I'm feeling good, thank you. I'm just glad to just keep my points scoring streak going. First of all, congrats to Ryan. He did a brilliant job. The guy's just on another level at this point. So, I felt like I did everything I could that race. I had a good start. And my pacing drive was pretty good. The only bit I felt I was struggling was probably that middle sector, where I just seen Ryan was getting so much more grip than me, and that just seemed to what made the difference to help him stay in front. But overall, yeah, I'm pretty happy with the race. Kept it clean. Just add another podium to Metalli. I really can't complain with that. And it's good points towards the constructors. So, yeah, overall, I'm pretty happy.
Good to hear. So, we saw in chat you were quite excited about the rain. Now, let's be honest, Vapid. Did you do a rain dance before you started this race?
I think I've been doing a rain dance for the past 2 weeks when I seen Austria was coming up. So... it kind of worked.
you did just briefly mention it when you were giving a little recap on your race. Sector 2, you seem to lose a lot of time to constant Ryan. Was that just a lack of grip, or was it just the fact that Shane was just sort of lining the corners up and sort of just that bit better than you were?
Well, I don't really know, to be honest, because I did see the sort of lines Shane, Ryan was taken, so I did try to implement that, but since I'm on the controller, I didn't have the actual proper steering lock, because ever since when I tried to do that specific line he was doing, it would just lock and it would just run me wide. So I don't know if it's just either I wasn't running enough downforce, or it's just something the pad just generally can't do. But overall, yeah, I just tried to make the best of the situation and just hope maybe he could pick up a penalty. And yeah, like I say, there was nothing I really could have done in that situation. I had to try everything to gain time through that part of the track, but it just wasn't meant to be.
Yeah, you always keep him within that DRS range as well of constant Ryan once we got into those dry conditions. Was there any part of you that was thinking at any point, you know what, I could actually take him, or was it just he's always that half a second or so ahead of me? He's getting those center exits out of, most vitally, turn 3. The traction that he seems to get out of turn 3 was just insane.
Yeah.
So was it ever sort of frustrating you, so to say?
A little bit, to be honest, because when I come to the end of the lap, I seen I was gaining on him again, and I got a really good exit out of turn 1 one time, and I seen he was running really low on ERS, but it was just like a tenth or two, just not enough. And it was the middle sector that I felt was making that specific difference, how he was gaining that much time to protect him from me launching that attack down into like turn 2 or turn 3. So overall, there was maybe a couple of opportunities that I did get really close, but it just was never going to be enough given how much I was losing in sector 2. So just got to take it on the chin and just we move on to the next race.
We do indeed. This does end a little run of 3 consecutive third places for you. Now you got yourself onto the second step of the podium. So it must be nice getting yourself up that little extra step on the podium, giving yourself those extra 3 points towards the championship standards, and trying to sort of stay in touch with Ryan just that little bit more.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it definitely does feel better. I felt like the last few races I've done, I feel like I was Max Verstappen in the 2020, just picking up the third places and sitting on the third place chair. So it was bugging me slightly, but you as a driver, you always want to be on the top step, and I'm not going to stop pushing until I get that, because I would like to get another one before the season ends. But yeah, like I say, I just need to keep driving at my best and just pick up on situations if anything arises in the final five races. So yeah, that's really it.
Indeed, Swayze, anything for you, bud?
No, man, congratulations, another solid drive from you. You know, it's good to see you've gone up a step. I hope you can push that forward and challenge for a race win.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us, Papin. And now moving on to our race winner, a man who we've spoken to quite a bit over the last few weeks. In fact, we've spoken to all three of these guys very frequently over the last few weeks. But Constant Ryan back on the top step of the podium once again. Constant Ryan, congratulations on the race win, my friend. Talk us through your race, mate.
Yeah, it was qualifying was interesting. I missed turn two on both laps like an absolute genius. Should have done it too, but coulda, shoulda, woulda. But the race, I'm sure you saw, cold front tires, no idea where to brake. And yeah, I messed up the stuff for turn one quite a lot, but just regained it and then pulled back on the track. I was being interested to see how the inters would have turned out, because they were scheduled, the rain was scheduled to dry up after the inters were like in puncture territory. So I was like, once I got into third place, I was like, okay, I'm just going to chill here and not try to overtake and just take care of my tires, just in case I get to that puncture danger zone. But then the safety car came out, that kind of took that out of the equation. And then after the safety car, I just kind of, well, I wanted to see what Vapid's pace was like. I was like, okay, is he using the ERS or not? And then, because like four laps later, I saw his red light flash, and I was like, okay, I'm going to try and get him now. So I got him on the straight, and I was like, okay, so let's try and maintain it. And first of all, well done to him, because like he really kept me honest there. Like, I wasn't lying when I posted that meme in the chat there with sweat of a guy sweating, because I really was there. I was really concentrating hard and trying to get the exits in the right place. I think I was just, the middle sector I felt very good in. The setup was working very nicely through there. The last two corners I felt nice too. Yeah, that was it. Just kind of kept it on the track and not make any stupid mistakes, which in the past I probably would have done, but yeah, I seem to be getting better as this game dies.
That's what we like to hear, though. So yeah, you did mention it there. We mentioned it briefly in the interview with Vapid as well. Sector 2, you just seem to gain so much time on Vapid through there. Vapid even mentioned that the input he was trying to put in on his pad was just not working for him. It was just so smooth and so effortless from you through that second sector. Was that sort of your strong point on this track here in Austria?
I think it was just two corners, really. It was the horseshoe section, the second left-hander that where it goes left-right. I noticed in the wet there I was taking a tenth and a half, 2 tenths every single lap. And I kind of kept a note with that and thinking, okay, I'm going when it dried up down the street, right, really try and nail that through there and see if it'll transfer into dry, and it did. Now, it wasn't that much, you're talking maybe a tenth or two, but around the track this short, that's a lot of time. But yeah, I think it was kind of there, really kind of helped me out.
So
other than that, I just kind of try to keep consistent as possible.
Yeah, you did mention at the start of the race, you had that little bit of a moment into T1, which knocked you down to fourth place. It was obviously very, very early on in the race, but at any point was your mind at the first few laps of this race going, oh my god, I've screwed up the potential win here?
No, I don't really panic. I'm just like, okay, let's try and salvage something, because you can lose the race in the first lap, but you can definitely, you know, keep yourself in contention. I just kind of chilled out there in the inters, because I knew once it dried up, that's when the overtaking was going to happen, because it's impossible to overtake in the wetter inters unless you're like, you know, over a second a lot faster than someone, which none of the top four were. Like, we're all pretty close, so I wasn't really too worried. As long as I was there, I knew I could be within a shout and kind of pick my moments properly, and it paid off. Indeed. The car was very quick in the straights, as which helped.
Did pay off indeed. I'm just looking at the standings, and in the last six races, somewhat similarly to Vapid, you followed a bit of a pattern. China second, Russia first, Brazil second, Mexico first, Bahrain second, Austria first. You like working in little patterns here, don't you, Gosner, Ryan?
Yeah, that really pleased my OCD, I must say. but yeah, this is just kind of ending up that way. Next race, I'm going to make sure I finish second. Have a 10-second lead. I'll slow down, actually. I want to go finish second. but just kind of in a good run of form, which is nice. I just feel comfortable. Still more to come, but, you know, that's what everyone says.
Of course, so confidence, obviously, key coming into the final five races of the season. We are going to Hungary next Saturday. How are you feeling about driving the Hungara Ring?
I haven't done it in a while, but in the past, I usually do go pretty well there, especially in the really twisty stuff. I feel I'm usually quite quick to there, because that's kind of my... I love high-speed change of direction a lot. It's really fun. It's fun in the wet as well, actually. Yeah. Taking is difficult there too, unless you're right on someone's gearbox down the straight. Other than that, you're gonna just have DRS trains probably. But yeah, see how it goes. Hoping it's not short quality, because for that, Hungary is a bit of a pain in the ass, because they have to basically do one shot, and I just hate too much short quality laps. But yeah, let's see how it comes around.
We shall sway in for the new bud to finish off.
Congratulations, man. A great race from you, man. I mean, obviously, you had a little bit of a bad start after your qualifying. You recovered really well. Great performance. Sturdy drive after you'd retaken the lead from Vapid and the driver of the day from me. So, congratulations, man.
Thank you very much.
There we go. Massive, massive congratulations to our podium here at Austria. But of course, this will now bring us to the end of our stream this evening. A massive, massive thank you to every single one of you who has stuck around and watched this evening's race. Myself and Swayze will be back next Saturday night at the, I believe, normal stream time of 8 p.m. Jamie?
Yeah, sorry, a bit preoccupied.
Yeah, so we will be back at the normal race time of 8 p.m. next Saturday night, guys, for the Hungarian Grand Prix from the Hungara Ring. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, from myself, Kieran Wright 92, and TES Swayze, thank you so much for watching, guys. We will see you next week. Good night.